What happened in school that still pisses you off when you think about it today? A couple weeks into my freshman year, I transferred into a more advanced science class. On my first day in the new class, there is a quiz. I asked the teacher if I was exempt from the quiz, since it was my first day. She said no. I did well, especially for not having been taught any of the material. Here's what bugged me. The final question on the test was, what country is ticket from? Of course I got it wrong. The sentence doesn't even make sense. She wouldn't give me any clarification during the test. So once it was graded, I asked what in the world she meant. Turns out ticket is her pet bird. Ticket. For one, capitalize the name of your pet. Also, that's not an appropriate test question. I told the teacher I had no idea that was her bird. She said, well, now that you know I'm talking about my bird, I'll give you another chance. What country is my bird from? I was stunned that she thought I was now equipped to answer this question. I wasn't in class to hear her reveal where her bird was from. I guessed something like Chile. She says, wrong. It's Africa. Africa? That's not a country. I was so mad. She also arrogantly proclaimed every so often for the first few weeks if anyone spotted her making an error, they get an instant A for the year. I can't count how many times I busted her in class. But she never stuck to her word. Last of all, some random girls I didn't even know told the teacher I taught the bird swear words. And I got in trouble for that. I never said a word, much less swear words, to her bird. Was talking to the guidance counselor about how it was ridiculous to me that a single missed assignment would drop my grade by 20-30 points, regardless of its importance. She said, just because something is wrong doesn't mean you should try to change it. Why the FCK would a guidance counselor give that type of advice to a freshman in high school? I found that a lot of guidance counselors were just bitter people who never got to be teachers. Both my parents are teachers and they hate their respective guidance departments. 9th grade. Was loading onto the bus in summer school. A kid sat in a seat that a girl wanted. I told him not to worry about her. She proceeded to slap the shit out of me. As she was rearing back to slap me again, I pushed her away. At that exact time, the driver gets on and sees me pushing her. We both go kicked out of summer school. I was only going so that I could graduate as a junior. She fk'd up my whole plan for high school. We had this multicultural fair at my elementary school and the faculty wanted a Japanese kid to do origami at the Japanese station. I was the only kid that knew origami. I was, and still am, Filipino. So, they had me pretend to be Japanese and do the paper cranes and frogs and shit. It was just ridiculous. If they did that now, shitty would hit the fan. In my last year of junior school, I arrived to find everyone gossiping about two friends and I being in trouble for some reason. We'd been accused of bullying this kid. We had to apologize to him. We got called to the headmaster, who blew his top. And our form teacher told us that she hoped we'd get bullied when we went to secondary school. Most of which would have fine. But when we went to apologize, I didn't so much as even recognize him, let alone know him or bully him. He turned out to be a good guy. So at least I made a friend for the final 3 months of school. Even to this day, I can't guess how this story originated. When I was 16, I started living by myself. One of the things that still pisses me off years later about the first year or so that I lived alone is that, even though my marks were actually improving at the time, there were still teachers who told me they liked me better when I lived with my parents. Yeah. Please, teacher, tell me more about how I should have moved back in with my abusive parents. In the second grade, our class was walking in a single file line outside for recess. It had rained and was muddy and slick. The class bully, a heavy-set mean girl, was walking ahead of me. She slipped in the mud and fell on her ass. She jumped up and immediately pointed her finger at me. That BTCH said I pushed her. I got detention for a few days and had to spend that recess with my hair down on a desk in the teacher's office. I swore I didn't do it and no one believed me. Whoa. That was like 1989 or 1990 and yeah. still pisses me off. I had to pee. Then I asked to go to the restroom. The substitute, full-time teacher for another class, said, "You don't have to pee. Just sit down." Double quote. After a bit more pleading and begging, I just peed my pants. I was 8 and totally mortified. What made it worse is that the teacher told my parents that I should have spoken up earlier and accidents happen. I still think I should have peed on her desk. Something like this happened when I was in high school. The kid just pulled a garbage can to the corner and pissed in it. We had a pregnant girl in one of our classes and she needed to pee. She told the teacher and the teacher told her she should have kept her legs closed and she wouldn't need to pee so badly. She stood up, walked over to the door, peed in her pants in front of it, and walked out. He got fired because she had a medical reason for needing to have constant bathroom breaks. A guy threw his cheat paper at me in an exam. The invigilator saw it, but instead of throwing him out of the class, he threw me and gave me an F in that exam. This is the most ridiculous thing I've heard today. A teacher told me I couldn't keep a bottle of water in my locker because it could be vodka or something. Double quote. I told her she could smell it and check. She said, "That's not my job and that I could just use the drinking fountain." I asked her if she would use the drinking fountain instead of her mug the tap in the teacher's lounge. She wouldn't answer. A girl in 3 of my classes was allowed by the administration to have her cell phone during classes because her father was dying. I was aware of the situation since it was happening for weeks and she often had little breakdowns. One day, in first period, her phone vibrates while the teacher is talking. He disregards that fact that she's allowed to have her phone and demands she hand it over to him. I believe he said something along the lines of, "I'll read it, and if it's not your mother then I'm keeping it, her phone, for the rest of the class because it rang while I was talking." Well, the girl flips out. Starts crying as soon as she sees her phone screen. She said no. She's leaving. This starts a standoff between the teacher and her. He ends up blocking the doorway while still demanding her phone. His logic was, if he didn't know it was her mom texting her, then he can't let her leave. At this point, she's inconsolable and everyone in the class is screaming at him to let her go. Like, fuck your complex, dude. Let her go. And he's screaming back, "I'm in charge here." To the point the class made so much noise that security came in to see what was going on. Security tells the girl, "Just go to the office." Her dad did die that day and she wasn't in school for a month. The teacher had a leave of absence as well and we had a sub the rest of the year. From then on, students were not allowed special circumstances for cell phones and teachers were not allowed to block students from leaving. The real kicker is, this was intro to photography and most students were there because we had to take a mandatory elective. Fuck you, Mr. M. You were a DCK to that poor girl who only wanted to see her dad one more time. I'm mad just typing this out. I was in the school finals of some general knowledge quiz competition. The question I was asked was, "What is the collective noun for a group of whales?" Double quote. I answered confidently, "A pod." The illiterate bloody teacher had a skull written on her answer card. Refused to listen when I assured her it was indeed a pod. Her ignorance cost me the grand title and I was practically in tears, in front of the whole school, at the injustice of it. Everyone then labeled me as a bad loser. Will never forget it. Still seethe on it from time to time. It happened in 1985. I had a friend in high school who was quite good at guitar. He played regularly and often outside of school. And sometimes at lunch. One day at lunch we were sitting in our usual social group. One girl was a bit of a stuck-up BTCH and more of an acquaintance. But did not like his soft strumming, I guess. He was playing softly and made good background music more than anything else. She says, "Can you stop playing your shitty guitar? No one likes it." Double quote. He gets up without batting an eye. Still playing. And sits by the empty hallway for the rest of lunch. After a second, I join him and so does another friend. We were all music students. And all knew how well our friend played and how important it was to him. He took it in stride. But I just don't get why she had to do it. Bitch just had to be a BTCH, I guess. We were all taking a class trip to the school library. Librarian said I couldn't drink my water in the library. No problem, I told her. I tightened the lid and put it in my bag. Out of sight. Nope. She grabbed my bag. Attached to me. Ripped it open and grabbed my water bottle and slammed dunked it in the trash can. Telling me. I said no. Like I was a dog. All 15 of us just stared at her. And I wasted my dollar to have my water trashed. I got detention for talking after someone talked to me. I didn't even reply and he didn't get punished. We don't even have similar voices. I had a good teacher in 10th grade who constantly told me to stop talking. I kept protesting that it seriously wasn't me. Eventually I told her, after class, to move me across the room and she'd see who it really was. She agreed and it worked. The very first day after moving she declared right in class, I was wrong, it was never AFK tornado. I'm so sorry. And proceeded to crack down on the guilty parties. Good teacher. Very validating. I got told off by the next person down from headmaster for not turning up to a maths lesson. Because he thought I'd gone to a demonstration against the rise in university tuition fees. He was, however, perfectly okay with the fact that I didn't go to the demonstration and just couldn't be asked to turn up to the maths lesson. Other people who did go to the demonstration got suspended. My stepfather was severely physically abusive and I got called to the guidance counselor's office often to explain the bruises. I would tell her what had happened. She'd call my mother. My mother would arrive. Tell everyone I was a liar and that I bruised myself for attention. And the GC always bought it and sent me home. Eventually I just stopped telling her anything other than I was clumsy because the beatings were always worse when the school called my parents. Edit. Seriously. Thanks for the supportive words. I had no idea so many of us had shitty parents and shitty guidance counselors. And no. I never beat the shitty out of him back. Didn't have to. He was in an accident at work that left him a drooling vegetable. Karma's a bitch. I had my person and all my belongings searched on 4/20 simply because of who I was and I was acting lethargic. The arsehole vice principal opened my bag and said it smelled like marijuana, in the pocket where I kept my cologne. Sent to ICE. My home away from home. Because they couldn't prove I was high. But. They knew I was. Definitely didn't smoke. Knowing something like this was coming. We had a huge midterm project that was going to be 20% of our overall grade. The subject was a person who had changed the world from their accomplishments. I spent over 40 hours of class time plus library time working on my research paper, PowerPoint and huge folding poster. To only get a C. I gave up on that class after this. And half-assed the end of the year project. Just put in simple text responses. One picture, etc. Got an A. FCK the public school system and giving teachers the right to grade as they please. Same thing happened to me. Did a why marijuana should be legal presentation. It was supposed to be on a controversial topic. Never had I ever put more work into a presentation as I was really passionate about the topic. Got a F. King C. Decided FCK this and didn't care about anything else, just did papers on boring subjects and never really wrote a thing of quality. Those papers I got fine grades on even though I wrote the like a drone. Next year I get the same project except this time it's a paper, different teacher, use the same stuff I researched the previous year and got an A on that paper. In elementary we had to listen to the teacher read a story. And then draw at the same time what was happening in the story. I went to get more pencils and noticed a drawing on the floor. I picked it up and asked who dropped it. The teacher shouts at me and says that I'm not listening the story and tells me to repeat what happened in it. I say what happened and the teacher says that I'm wrong. Then she asked someone else what happened and they say the same thing. And the teacher says they're right. Piss me off so much. Year 7. About 12 years old. Regular school. Two students with vision impairments. Student 1 has had cataracts and related problems. Student 2 has an underdeveloped fovea. Severe myopia. Nystagmus. and other low vision issues. A handout is passed around. Student 1 can see it. Student 2 cannot. Integration coordinator drags student 2 out of classroom to scream at her in the hall. Door open, that if student 1 can see it then stop faking blindness for attention. Same teacher made fun of student 2 getting a cane. When I was in high school I transferred schools at the beginning of second semester. My old school was ahead of my new school when it came to math. For example, at my old school you took algebra a year before you would take it at my new school. So the new school puts me in the math class that corresponds with my grade level, but I'm bored because I already took this class at my old school. So my guidance counselor bumps me up a level. I was only in the class one day before the teacher decided I had missed too much and wouldn't be able to catch up, even though my old school had already covered a little more material. The best part? That day in class she had asked a question and none of her students knew the answer even though several of them tried. I answered the question correctly. 10 years later it still makes me mad I didn't fight harder to stay in that class. When I was a sophomore in high school this kid got really sick with mono. So bad he was hospitalized. And the principal announced over the whole school about this kid. He said if you wanted to make a card for him and his family you could drop it off at the front office. Of course this kid was an athlete and a popular kid. Well, about a week later I was hospitalized with histoplasmosis. It's an illness that attacks the lungs and damn near killed me due to the treatment I was taking. Well, I got better and went back to school after about a month of being in the hospital and in a coma. When I get back, no one realized I was that bad off. I asked if the school let everyone know and the school didn't. It just bugs the shit out of me. Because I knew just about everyone in my class and no one knew I was in the hospital and could die. Not even one single card was sent to me. I cared but didn't care enough to make a huge stink about it. What really pissed me off was my shitty English teacher who failed me and treated me like shitty when I got back. When she told me I would fail even though I had taken the final and got a B. I got up and walked out of her class after calling her a shitty teacher. I took the class over again during the summer. But that still pisses me off how I was treated differently because I didn't play sports. I went to a small private Christian school. Had 12 people in our senior class. We decided to skip an hour and go to Dennis for breakfast one morning. So it comes time to ditch and no one goes. Everyone chickens out. It was me and one other kid that ended up going. The other kid didn't make friends easily and in such a small school it is easy to single someone out. He was kind of known as being troubled. Weird. No friends, etc. Well, I coaxed him into ditching with me. Figured it would be a good experience for him and make him feel a little less alone at school. So we eat our breakfast and go back to school. Teachers and principal are wondering where we went, so we just tell them we went to go get breakfast. I get detention and this other kid gets suspended for 2 days. They said he was a bad influence on me. I hated that so much. I felt so bad I couldn't get him out of trouble. Sorry, Ben. The first math test of the semester. Did an extra step on every equation. God knows why. Every problem had the answer in the work but an incorrect answer circled. Still got a zero. One kid didn't even take the test, had an unexcused absence for the day. Teacher made a deal with him for extra credits that would negate the test provided he didn't have any more unexcused absences. I had perfect attendance, no extra credit for me. Signed up with a tutor who helped me a lot. The lady was really a hero, but I still needed a crazy high score on the next test just to keep from failing. Me and the tutor studied like crazy. Teacher pushed the test back by a day and added more material. I wasn't confident about the material but teacher wouldn't help me. And my tutor was unavailable until after the test. Just before the test I came to the teacher's office, begged them to let me take the test a few hours later. So my tutor could explain the new material to me during my off period. I cried and everything. Teacher said yes. But I still had to be in the classroom while everyone else took the test. Class starts. Teacher passes out tests and says it's been brought to my attention that some of you are struggling with the new material. It was unfair of me to spring that on you with such short notice. So we are going to take the test as a class, effectively guaranteeing everybody 100%. I try to pick up a test. Teacher grabs my hand and says I already made a deal and can't go back on it. Pretty much tells the whole class I was crying in their office. Made me sit there and watch everyone get handed an A. I took the test a few hours later, got a B+, still not enough to pass. Had to retake it in summer school. Never took math beyond Gen Ed. Again, still hate it today because of that teacher. 7th grade, my dad's affairs came to light. He told us all to FCK ourselves and left. My sister was struggling with drugs and family life was falling apart. Not surprisingly, I acted out in school and failed. We moved that summer, but not before the principal took it a parting shot and told my grandfather, taking care of kids while my mom got set up with a new job in another state, I'm a loser and I'd never amount to anything. I took the failure to heart and got my shit together. When I graduated from a top 10 engineering school, my grandfather drove us back to the school to give the principal a copy of my degree and told him to go FCK himself. Petty but feels effing great. As a third grader, we had silly games, one of which involved pulling each other pants down in front of everyone. Just as someone else did that to me. One of the professors that was known for being a huge CNT spotted me with my pants down and thought I did it by myself. She dragged me to the fifth grader's class and made me pull my pants down in front of the entire class to teach me a lesson. I was terrorized and the bullying that came with it still resides in my unconsciousness. 3 days or so before my term paper was due senior year of high school, I was working on it at my uncle's place. I had papers, notes, rough drafts, and the like spread out all over the table. I was alone that night and there was an intense thunderstorm. Let me take you through the next 4 seconds. Tangible pressure change. Lights go out. Roof tears off. Telephone poles, plural, rain down into the house. For the sake of relevancy, I'll skip the details of my obvious escape from death. Act 2. I tell my teacher my term paper was destroyed in a tornado. My suspicion was that it was the same one that destroyed my house. But sadly, no usable prints at the scene. She never got my humor either. At any rate, may I have an extension? I can let you present yours last, but it's still due the same day. There was an oral component. How in the frenzied bowels of hell is that helpful? So now, fueled by illegally procured Ritalin and righteous loathing for the soulless CNT who's standing on the throat of my diploma, I write the whole thing over again. Act 3. The rule for the presentation was it must be 5 minutes or longer. No. Maximum. Time. I volunteered to present second. I presented the entire length of her class period and into her lunch period. She had to postpone every other term paper to a later date. Essentially giving the entire class. Save 2. An extension. I heard she died a few years ago. Now every time I see a rainbow after a storm, I know it's just God saying. I made it right. She won't hurt anyone again. Double quote. TLDR, tornado ate my term paper. Busy teacher sets aside the time to tell me to eat a dick. I filibuster her ass and then God kills her. 2 things. I was suspended for walking down a hallway and having some doucher bag knock me out. I literally didn't say anything to instigate it. I was just walking and he decided that my head should become friends with the wall. And I was effing suspended for fighting. I literally couldn't fight back. I just woke up in the nurse's office like 5 minutes later in pain. 2. I asked my teacher what the current algebra equation was using to solve. Like, what did this or whatever represent, because some context would help me understand it better. He responding by saying that it represented me flipping burgers at McDonald's because that's all I would ever amount to. Then proceeded to call me a fattus, even though I had lost like 30 pounds that year and was finally at a just barely above average weight, and said he hoped I liked the taste of fries and burgers. I got him fired. He now can't get any job in the education field. He now flips burgers at McDonald's. Yes. The smug satisfaction is glorious.